When that I was and a little tyne boy, with hay on the wind and the rain, a foolish thing was but a toy, for the rain it raineth every day. But when I came to man's estate, with hay all the wind and the rain, gainst knaves and thieves men shut their gate, for the rain it raineth every day. But when I came, alas, to wine, with hay all the wind and the rain, by swaggering could I never thrive, for the rain it raineth every day. But when I came unto my beds, with hay all the wind and the rain, with pots still had drunken heads, for the rain it raineth every day. A great while ago the world begun, with hay all the wind and the rain, but that's all what a play is done. And we'll strive to please you every day.
Scholars have for a long time made the default assumption that songs in Shakespeare's works are not by Shakespeare simply because of how different they sound, from how different the text sounds from the verse in Shakespeare's plays. And the people think, well, these songs, they're so sappy and they're so kind of chunky, as opposed to the refined poetry of Shakespeare's verse, they could never have been written by a poet so brave as William Shakespeare. The problem, in my mind, with that interpretation of Shakespeare's songs is it's interpreting Shakespeare's songs as poetry, as spoken poetry, which they are not. And I would think that a dramatist as great as William Shakespeare would understand the different mode that he would need to be in when writing song, as opposed to poetry, and how words are different when they are sung versus when they are spoken, and how sentiments that seem sappy and overdone spoken are actually quite fitting and in place and beautiful when sung. And so thankfully contemporary scholarship is moving more towards looking at the songs in Shakespeare's plays as Shakespeare, not as interpolations of popular ballads at the time or what have you. But this particular song is problematic because, first of all, it's actually referenced in King Lear, which points you to sort of thinking that that song must be in the ballad repertoire and it must be a song that people know. It's possible that people in King Lear knew it from Twelfth Night. I think that chronologically works out. Yes, I do see a nod. But also the first four verses, which tell the story of aging and growing up and losing the ability to be a fool. Once you become an adult, you're responsible for things. Believe it or not, I'm figuring that out now. And the last verse, great while ago the world begun, hey ho, the wind and the rain, but that's all when our play is done, and we'll strive to please you every day. It sounds very much like a tack-on. So it's possible that this was an Elizabethan song that people knew, that Shakespeare added a little thing at the end.
But when I came, alas, to wine, Glory.